Ready?
Okay, I'm James from Aussie Swag Campers. We've been manufacturing this product for over 27 years now. It's a family business. Mum and Dad, myself, my brother and my wife all run this business, makes a beautiful product. One of the biggest selling points of the Aussie Swag is the kitchen. At home, where do we function around? It's a kitchen. Why not do it when you're camping? Got a huge stainless steel slide-out pantry, cutlery, cooking needs, it's all on fingertips. Self-closing stainless steel catches, not a finger. No movement, it's always the way we do things at Aussie Swag. Again, in and out. Sealed bearings are always used. Built-in cutting board. Cutting, preparation, it's inbuilt. Into the pot. This model has a diesel hot water system, so you have hot and cold water on hand. Four burners on top, griller, also flame failure. So if the burners happen to go out, you've got automatic cut off of the gas. A unique feature of the Aussie Swag is when the kitchen spins around and slides back in, the gas has auto gas cut off. This turns off automatically. Without this feature, you will not comply with current regulation of gas. So it's a great feature. No bayonet fitting required, permanently connected to water and gas. Refrigeration, it's very important. Again, at home, we can't live without it. And we live around the corner from a corner store. So out in the bush, you need refrigeration that's going to keep on running day in, day out. At Aussie Swag, we have perfected it. 27 years, we've got an 80 litre Waco, easily has a flip over stainless steel bench, slides away. But what runs it? Well, that's a great feature. What runs this refrigerator is batteries. Generator is not standard on this particular model, can be used, or 135 watt solar panel. Whilst it's in situ there, I haven't taken off, we don't need the power, we've got plenty of amp hours available. So in a normal conditions, set up camp, this will come off, two legs, out in the sun, generating electricity. Today, the conditions, that will keep up. So other features of the camper, the suspension underneath is a galvanised chassis. Don't like the use of Duragal, spray painted, powder coated, whatever you call it, hot dip galvanising, we know, is the superior. The sub axle, another unique feature. Most campers will have a welded-in stub. That's a weak link of an independent suspension. The stub axle is removable. So it is a great feature. And it has been called upon on our customers, belying otherwise. The tailgate of the trailer, can't show you, but a great feature is when the trailer is closed, a drawer pulls out from the rear of the trailer so the camper can be packed without opening it up. Kitchen packed, fridge packed, clothes packed, all at home. So the same drawer is inside. Accessible when the trailer's open. Massive. Shoes, clothes, general camping gear, all goes in the drawer. We mentioned about the power factor. 315 amp hours of sealed AGM batteries. They're not just sealed AGM batteries, they are Decca Seamate. Google it, it's well respected. Is the advantage of the Decca Seamate batteries, they are current unlimited. Some batteries, and a lot of them, are restricted by the current. Therefore, if you choose to install a very high capacity battery charger, which we're using the Pro Steerling Ultra, it's 60 amps. So out in the bush, the solar panel can't keep up because it could be great weather. You can't collect it because of the shade of the trees. Therefore, with a generator on board, run it through the Pro Ultra, 60 amps per hour. Do the math, quick charging. The other benefit of this battery charger, it's one unique, it accepts dirty charge, which means we don't like to promote them, but a GMC $99 generator, most chargers will be affected by the circuit board. This has an open circuitry on AC that allows cheaper generators to be operated. Want to know what's happening with the battery? We have a battery monitor. It's a Victron showing you volts, amps. For those who don't understand, simply leave it on SOC, state of charge, gives you a percentage. Currently right now, we've got 95.8% left in the batteries. Water level gauge showing you how much water is left. Four green lights represents full. Diesel heating. So that blows hot air using from the Webasto unit. The inverter. It's a pure sine wave. 700 watt is the capacity. So miscellaneous things like your camera batteries, phone batteries, video cameras, etc. can be used. 12 volt power sockets can be operated with miscellaneous appliances. Not only do we use a circuit breaker, this is an RCD, it's not compulsory in this industry, we use one. So it's just a bit of step up from a general circuit breaker. Storage pockets down the side, so when you are in bed, you can access things, books, glasses, etc. from the side bins. Another great feature is the tropical roof. It's been standard since Aussie Swag since 2001, a first in the camper trailer industry. Also, in addition, a vent. You know where hot air will go, it rises. In wintertime, condensation will be eliminated by having that exposed and open. Even one half can be left open, one half closed, or portion of it. Windows also open up for hot conditions, so insects aren't a problem, isn't today. We could leave these windows open, maximising airflow. Bedside reading light, standard equipment, inner spring mattress. We use made to measure, traveller. Going out on the other side, we have an awning. Whilst you didn't see me set up, these awnings were already attached to the trailer when opened. I didn't need to zip these on, they were on. The only thing I put up here today is this shower room. So you simply walk outside the trailer into the shower room, and it's nylon. You don't want canvas. Canvas will be affected by all chemicals, so detergents and shampoos, no, it's nylon. Can be shaken and dried very quickly. Inside the unit, again, this is the diesel unit. In fact, it's ready to go. Since I've been setting up, I've simply just flicked the switch and it heats. So right now we can draw water from the trailer's water, which is 130 litres of water. Or we can have a jerry can, bucket of water. You may have got it from the creek, bore water tap, put it into the bucket, and simply by rotating this switch, arrow is pointing trailer side, that represents trailer water. Pointing it towards the drawbar will draw water from the external position. So in a minute, I will go and turn the water pump on, which I don't think it is, no, and that water would pump through. So it's up to you guys if you like to see that. Ventilation in the shower room, so again, in cold conditions, we allow still airflow during the day. It can be opened up, closed off to shower with. Look, overall, the product is a goodie. It's always worked, always has. We aren't the biggest manufacturer, that's why we like it. We don't market as maybe as others, but it's a great product, we've got a strong following. So thanks for listening to me. It's Aussie Swag Campers.
Thanks for walking us around, James. It's we just had one of these up in the Kimberley with us. They're built really well, but I guess what I've always liked about them is just the quality.
Yep.
You know, you don't really scan any corners on these things.
No, that's right.
So, I mean, because a lot of these things have lots of the features and stuff, but yeah, these days it's nice to see people just building them right from the ground up.
Yep.
So, I guess another 12 volt.
There's additional 12 volt outlets around the trailer. So there's one on the outside, two more inside. So addition of that's 235.
Jerry's and gas.
Yep, sure, we missed that end, didn't we?
Yep.
The front end unit, important area, would be good. Okay, on the front of the trailer we have a DO35 coupling, mated with a DO35 handbrake. We continue using branded products. We know we can buy couplings imported, but, you know, everything we use has a brand to it. You can ensure the quality. The Basto unit actually is stored in this box, in with the water pump. The unit itself is operating there, very quiet. A key feature of the Basto is our, underneath the trailer, if you have time to have a look, the piping is lagged, which is a covering over the pipes. As the heater pipe runs through, if it's not lagged, which our cars often aren't, some aren't, is it loses heat. When it loses heat, the unit will fire up and use 12 volt power supply. You want to conserve the 12 volt power supply. So if you look underneath, it's lagged. The heater into the unit's lagged. So it's a sponge rubber holding it in. If you get your normal Webasto, put your hand on it, it's hot. Lagging, it's not. The diesel tank, jerry cans, fuel or water or one of each or both.
Diesel tank last?
Like always, it's like battery supply, how much you use it, where you are. Cold conditions, you could go a couple of weeks without with running heating particularly easily, but that exceeds that by far in most conditions. It's not all the time you're using heating, but on spec, up to about half a litre, a bit under, but I like to overdo it, half a litre an hour. But of course, it's only using that consumption when it's been used. So 2 4 kg gas bottles, stone guard, preventing the bounce back of stones. Also, you might time to look is it's padded. The stone hasn't hit any hard object. It's padded. Yes, so that's the front end. Sorry about that. I didn't miss one thing. 12-inch electric brakes are used. It does. I haven't erected them today. It does come with a wall, which pegs to the ground, both ends. A skirt that covers the wheel section. A section we do call an infill. This is called sail track. It's extruded. A section tracks into the extrusion and velcros across. Very quickly, I can have this kitchen out. If it was raining here today, right now, I can simply zip on a wall, put the infill up, cooking not done, 3 minutes.
So the infill is obviously between there and that velcro there?
Correct. Yes, this triangle of black velcro.
Is that stored in the bag?
Yeah, what is it?
Yeah, that's not the cash that cash sales we get. It is canvas work, so it can be utilised for anything. In fact, a lot of the time, I prefer not to have the bag, but each to their own. I often have my canvas goods. They come in canvas bags in the back of my four-wheel drive, and utilise that for harder objects like firewood, etc.